I'm running for your heart. I'm running for your heart. Till I am a soul on fire, Lord. I'm running for your ways. I'm waiting for the day. I've been walking the same old road for miles and miles. If you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, He's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, He's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, He's a chain breaker. We all search for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run to things we know just ain't right. When there's a better life, there's a better life. If you got pain, He's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, He's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, He's a chain breaker. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, well, he's a chain breaker.
Good morning, church. Good morning. The Lord be with you. Thank you, and it is good to be with you. If we haven't met yet, I'm Pastor Burdick, your new pastor here at St. John's, and it has been a good week of getting to know one another, walk together. Thank you to all of you who came to last Sunday's installation service as well, hearing those holy texts, praying those holy things, and asking for God's blessing not only on me, but on us as we walk together in faithfulness to God and love to our neighbor. Here are some announcements for this week. The collection for Operation Christmas Child is now open. You'll find boxes for packing out on the table in the main hallway. I want to remind you that St. John's is going to host a trunk or treat on Sunday, October 27th, 2 weeks from today, beginning at 4. And I also want to invite you to check out the house out there at the corner of Oak and Jefferson. That is now our house, and that this week or this month, the youth board's working together to transform into what we're calling a house of fear and blessings. Certainly a connection there with Halloween, but a focus upon, yes, there are things in this world that we think we ought to fear, when in fact the only one to fear is God, and we can also love and trust him. But a house of fear and blessings, come by for a preview of how you might be able to help with the decorations over there, and know that the youth board that's working on that, they could use your help. So please volunteer. And finally, be sure to get signed up today, it's the last day, for the adult fellowship group trip up to Yoder's Kitchen. It is good to be together in God's house to receive his gifts. We begin with the first song that leads us into worship. Welcome in the name of Jesus.
There's a little flame inside us all. Some shine bright, some shine small. The rains will come and the waters rise. But don't you ever lose your light. In this life you will know love and pain, joy and sorrow. So when it hurts, when times get hard, don't forget whose child you are. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, gonna let it shine. May you live each day with no regret. Make the most of every chance you get. Let your eyes get wide when you look at the stars. With the same sense of wonder as a child's heart. With the ones you love, treasure the time. And for those who are gone, keep the memories alive. Hold on to your dreams, don't ever let go. There's a fire inside you burning. there'll be no more pain, and we will finally see Jesus' face. So until then, I'm gonna try to brave the dark and let my little light shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, gonna let it shine. Oh, shine, gonna let it shine. There's a little light inside us all.
Stand with me, please. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord has sent redemption to his people. He has commanded his covenant forever. The Lord has sent redemption to his people. Holy and awesome is his name. Let us confess. Let us confess our sins unto God and implore his forgiveness for the sake of his Son, Jesus Christ. I, a poor sinner, plead guilty before God of all sins. I have lived as if God did not matter and as if I mattered most. My Lord's name I have not honored as I should. My worship and prayers have faltered. I have not let his love have its way with me, and so my love for others has failed. There are those whom I have hurt, and those whom I have failed to help. My thoughts and desires have been soiled with sin. I am sorry for all of this, and ask for grace to forgive my sins, and for the Holy Spirit, so that I may amend my sinful life. You have spoken truth, and hear this truth too, that Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, has had mercy upon us, and has given to us his only Son to suffer and die for our salvation. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you show mercy to your people in all their troubles. Grant us always to recognize your goodness, give thanks for your compassion, and praise your holy name through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. The Old Testament reading is found in the book of Ruth, chapter 1, verses 1 through 19. In the days when the judges ruled, there was a famine in the land, and a man of Bethlehem in Judah went to sojourn in the country of Moab. He and his wife and his two sons, the name of the man was Elimelech, and the name of his wife Naomi, and the names of his two sons were Malon and Chilion. They were Ephraites from Bethlehem in Judah. They went into the country of Moab and remained there. But Elimelech, the husband of Naomi, died, and she was left with her two sons. These took Moabite wives. The name of the one was Orpah, and the name of the other Ruth. They lived there about 10 years, and both Malon and Chilion died, so that the woman was left without her two sons and her husband. Then she rose with her daughters-in-law to return from the country of Moab, for she had heard in the fields of Moab that the Lord had visited his people and given them food. So she set out from the place where she was with her two daughters-in-law, and they went on their way to return to the land of Judah. But Naomi said to her two daughters-in-law, "Go, return each of you to your mother's house. May the Lord deal kindly with you as you have dealt with the dead and with me." The Lord grant that you may find rest, each of you in the house of her husband. Then she kissed them, and they lifted up their voices and wept. And they said to her, No, we will return with you to your people. But Naomi said, Turn back, my daughters. Why will you go with me? Have I yet sons in my womb that they may become your husbands? Turn back, my daughters. Go your way, for I am too old to have a husband. If I should say I have hope, even if I should have a husband this night and should bear sons, would you therefore wait till they are grown? Would you therefore refrain from marrying? No, my daughters, for it is exceedingly bitter to me for your sake that the hand of the Lord has gone out against me. Then they lifted up their voices and wept again. And Orpah kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth clung to her. And she said, See, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and to her gods. Return after your sister-in-law. But Ruth said, Do not urge me to leave you or to return from following you. For where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God my God. Where you die, I will die, and I will be buried. May the Lord do so to me, and more, also, if anything but death parts me from you. And when Naomi saw that she was determined to go with her, she said, No more. So the two of them went on until they came to Bethlehem. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm reading is Psalm 111, found on page 5 of your bulletin, and we'll read responsively. Praise the Lord. I will extol the Lord with all my heart.
In the council of the upright and in the assembly.
Great are the works of the Lord.
They are pondered by all who delight in them.
Glorious and majestic are his deeds.
And his righteousness endures forever.
He has caused his wonders and to be remembered.
The Lord is gracious and compassionate.
He provides food for those who fear him.
He remembers his covenant forever.
He has shown his people the power of his works.
Giving them the lands of other nations.
The works of his hands are faithful and just.
All his precepts are trustworthy.
They are established forever and ever.
Enacted in faithfulness and uprightness.
He provided redemption for his people.
He ordains his covenant forever, holy and awesome is his name.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
All who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belongs eternal grace.
The epistle reading is found in the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2, verses 1 through 13. You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace that is in Christ Jesus, and what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses to entrust to faithful men, will be able to teach others also. Share in the suffering as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. No soldier gets entangled in civilian pursuits, since his aim is to please the one who enlists him. An athlete is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. It is the hardworking farmer who ought to have the first share of the crops. Think over what I say, for the Lord will give you understanding in everything. Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, the offspring of David, as preached in my gospel, for which I am suffering, bound with chains as a criminal. But the word of God is not bound. Therefore I endure everything for the sake of the elect, and that they also may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. The saying is trustworthy, for if we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Now even more, the report about Jesus went abroad, and great crowds gathered to hear him and to be healed of their infirmities. Hallelujah. Stand with me, please, for the reading of the Holy Gospel that will also serve as the sermon text this morning. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 17th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, Jesus said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, came back, praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, "Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" And then he said to him, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
In the name of Jesus Christ, the light of the world, grace, mercy, and peace to you. Amen. It's been a week of travel for us. Well, 10 days of travel as we came to Effingham with some pain of leaving a place and a people that we love to a people who've received us with love, and who I'm sure with confidence in Christ, we also will love as much. It's been a week of travel, like Jesus is traveling in the gospel lesson, and like those men travel, who once had leprosy, and then found in Jesus light and truth and grace. I could also say it's been a week of cardboard. Lots and lots of cardboard in our life. If I put a number on it, we probably have about 75% of our things that were in cardboard out and into some semblance of a proper place. It's also been a week of cards. Not cardboard, but cards. Numerous cards received from you last Sunday after, and some before, my installation. Cards that you obviously carefully chose. I am amazed that some card makers make very specific cards for receiving a pastor and his wife into a congregation. You chose them carefully, and many of you also wrote personal words in your own handwriting with your own personal prayers of encouragement and welcome. So there's been cardboard. And there have been cards to welcome us this week. We thank you, Kathy and Abby and I. We're living in a new community, and we're finding it to be, by God's grace, a wonderful place to be. You know that those 10 lepers of which we heard in Luke chapter 17, they lived in a community. But not a community of their choosing. These 10 men had to live together, and they had to live separate from other people because of their leprosy, not just from the medical standpoint, but really from the theological, that they were unclean ceremonially. They had to live together, but keep their distance. They had to be outsiders. From a distance, they had to say, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. We live not just in the community of Effingham and St. John's, but we live in this whole world that's broken and fallen and dying. We live in that kind of a community where people are isolated. Maybe it is that you live in isolation because of things you've done. Or maybe it's because of things that other people have done or left undone. Maybe there are barriers in your marriage, in your family, in church, in the community. Barriers that all stem from what? From sin in all of us. That erect divisions. The lepers could understand that kind of a community that includes so much isolation. We are broken and we are dead people by our own nature, cut off and cut down, too often ungrateful and always in our nature unholy. Those 10 lepers knew that they were outsiders. But apparently they also knew something about Jesus. They'd heard in Luke chapter 5 that he was a healer. And so they came to him with a request, not asking for what they deserved. They came asking for what they needed. Jesus, Master, have pity. Have mercy on us. They believed something true about Jesus Christ. And they received mercy. 10 men who had lived in this isolation community were healed that day by the power, by the word of God. The same word that had brought heaven and earth into being at the very beginning, that same word spoken by the Son of God healed these men and revitalized them. Not just the grateful man was healed, all 10 of them were. Do you know what that's like? Of course you do. To be cleansed. To be washed. Some of you were baptized in that font with water and word, and you were healed of a disease far worse than leprosy, of your sin and your dying. In coming to the Lord's Supper the last time, you received cleansing, washing, healing, and revitalization. Every time you turn one to another in the name of Jesus in your family and you say, I forgive you, there is a revitalization taking place. You know what it's like to be like these 10 lepers, to be healed and to grow into gratefulness. The irony, the wonderful gospel irony, is that your healing in life came by, of all things, him being sick. You were raised up by him dying. You were brought in by him being isolated, being outside literally the city gates of Jerusalem and outside of the mercy of God. You know what he said on the cross. My God, why have you forsaken me? And by God's grace, you know the answer. He was forsaken so that you never would be. You are absolved, brought in, and brought into the righteousness of God because Jesus was traveling. In the text, Jesus was traveling to Jerusalem knowing exactly what was ahead for him. Intentionally, he set his face toward Jerusalem, knowing about the cross. And knowing where he was going, he chose to go through Samaria. He chose to go where there were outcasts, half-breeds, where outcasts like you and me live. He has traveled here to you, to us, not waiting for you to ask, and not waiting for you to be grateful, but coming to you who, yes, are quite isolated in ways. Maybe in your family, maybe in the church, maybe in the community. Isolated, but also believing this. Paul's words to the Ephesians in chapter 2, but you who are in Christ Jesus, you who once who were far away, you've been brought near by the blood of Christ Jesus. There's no distance. There is grace. And grace grows gratitude. We will probably this Thanksgiving hear this same gospel text from Luke 17. Thanksgiving Day. We hear about it that 10 were healed, and how many returned thanks? One did. And on Thanksgiving, I suppose we're hearing that lesson so that we learn the lesson. Remember, be grateful. Be thankful. But today on the day of my first sermon among us, we're not focusing simply on that one. We're focusing on all 10 of these men. In order to focus on Jesus. Because all 10 of them were cleansed. All 10 by the power of God in Christ. Today we focus on those men grateful for our receiving of his word. We know how we teach children to learn to have manners, right? When they want something, a lot of times we'll say, well, what do you say? And we're prompting them to say, please, or to say, thank you. And that's necessary. You know why? Because we're ruined people. We need to be taught. We are inward focused. We need to be taught. But long term, how do you teach a child and older children to be full of gratitude. Nothing less and nothing more than grace. Grace in the home, grace in the church. God's truth received grows gratitude. When I was working on this text this week, I was thinking about a woman who went shopping at an odd time of the day. I mean, she intentionally decided to go shopping at a time when she wouldn't bump into anybody at the store. You know how that is, right? You go to the store very early in the morning or very late at night, just hoping to be, well, by yourself. She did that because she knew that the things that she had done in life and the things that had been done to her were painful and made people judge her. And she was judged by her own conscience and by the word of God. And then along came Jesus. She was a Samaritan too. She was shopping in the heat of the day at a well. John chapter 4. Jesus Christ comes and meets her who wants to be isolated, and he exposes her sin so that he can forgive her, so that she can know the grace of God in Christ. And after she meets with Jesus, what does she do? She goes back into her village and she says, "Come, meet a man who told me everything I've ever done." Can this be the disciples? Can this be the Messiah? You bet it is. Come meet this man for whom I'm grateful, for his grace grows gratitude. And so it was in the life of the one man who comes back to Jesus saying, "Praise God for my cleansing. Praise God for his cleansing to us today in the water and the word of baptism, in the Lord's Supper of his body and his blood, and in the power of his word. Thank God for his grace that avails for us." It's been a week of cardboard and gracious cards and words of welcome. But you know what's better than that? The grace of God overflowing to all of us as we gather in his service. And we get to hear Jesus say to us what he said to the one man who returned thanks: "Rise and go. Your faith, as long as it is in the Lord Jesus Christ, crucified and risen, your faith in him has made you well. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen." Rise with me, please, and stand and confess your faith, not just to one another, but also to the community, to others, in the words of the Nicene Creed, printed for you on page 18 in the bulletin. What do you believe? "I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
welcomed by the Lord. We come to present before Him the prayers of His people, trusting in His wisdom and grace to grant us all things in Christ for our good and for the good of all people. Let us pray. Blessed Lord, You led Ruth to know You, and by Your Spirit taught her fearful heart to trust in You for the future that You had prepared. Grant us the same Spirit, so that we, who know Your mercy in Christ, trust in Your eternal mercy in Jesus Christ for this life, for our forgiveness, and for our eternal salvation. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, of all things, You've granted Your people Your presence and grace from age to age, that where Your Word dwells, You are present with forgiveness and life. Grant to Your church and those who minister to us in Your name the grace of Your Spirit, that we hear Your words and believe it, keep it in holy hearts, live it out in faithfulness to Your baptismal gift, and proclaim it to the ends of the earth. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Mighty Lord, You hold all things in Your hand, including all the might of man. Give to us wise and faithful leaders who will guide and govern Your people according to Your commands, and who will protect the weak and the most vulnerable, including the unborn, the orphaned, the widowed, and the infirm. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy God, You are holy and righteous and have clothed us with the holiness and righteousness of our Savior Jesus Christ. Grant us to desire and strive for holiness of life, doing the good You desire, avoiding the evil that contradicts Your gracious will and purpose. Lord, in Your mercy, merciful Lord, You granted hope to the lepers, and You gave them healing according to Your will and Your purpose. So we pray You to grant all the sick and the suffering, the troubled in mind and heart, the grieving and the dying, the full measure of Your grace and Your strength. Especially we pray for Nick Miller, Craig Wolf, the family of Dave Sauer, Lori Mayberry, Nick Althoff, Howard Hake, Becky Reagan, Zach Fritcher, Mildred Rankin, Marion Tolch, and these who in silence we name. Guard them against the temptation to doubt or to despair. Keep them by Your word through the days of their affliction, that when the ills of this mortal life shall cease, and we shall live the full abundant life of promise. Lord, in Your mercy, we give You thanks at the 50 years of marriage granted to Don and Patsy Latch to be celebrated this week. We give You thanks for the 90th birthday of Ralph Stuckemeyer, and today the 100th birthday of Velma Wagner. We give You thanks and we pray for Corinne Tappendorf and Tony Castillo as they are married this coming Saturday. Shape them and all who are married according to Your design, wisdom, repentance, forgiveness, and obedience. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. Generous Lord, You daily provide mercies new and continue to nourish and nurture us in Your favor through all adversity. Instill in us a grateful heart, that we would not presume Your goodness, but live thankful and joyful lives because You've heard our cry and You have delivered to us all what we need for this body and life and for everlasting life. Lord, in Your mercy, hear our prayer. God of grace, Your saints have loved and served You and have provided a blessed example to us in our striving. Grant us the fortitude of Ruth, that we live in confidence of Your presence and Your guidance all of our days, until at last You bring us to our final home, where with all of Your saints we will live in Your presence forevermore. Lord, in Your mercy, gracious God, You not only supply all things for daily bread for this life, but have granted to us the bread that is Christ's body and the cup of His blood, with which we're fed and nourished all the way to everlasting life. Keep us from an unworthy communion, because we doubt the forgiveness here offered. Lord, in your mercy. O Father of all mercies, God of our salvation, give to us all things good and holy and true, and build us up in these things, that knowing your saving grace in Christ, we not fall victim to pride, temptation, or doubt, but endure all the changes of this mortal life with hope and peace through Jesus Christ, to whom we commend ourselves and all our prayers, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Be seated, please, as we worship the Lord with our offering. As we sing, give thanks.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks, for He has given Jesus Christ His Son. The Holy One, give thanks, for He has given Jesus Christ His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give Him thanks and praise. Yes, it is truly good, right and salutary, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for making all things and still preserving them, and most especially for your grace in delivering up your own Son, Jesus, in the flesh, to be our Savior and Redeemer. What was fulfilled in him and what he has prepared for our salvation, give to us according to your mercy, that we be fed and nourished with his flesh, offered up for our sin, and be cleansed by our communion in his blood. Give to us your Holy Spirit, that we may come in repentance and faith, and keep in holy lives what we now receive upon our lips. And by this Holy Supper, grow us in your grace and your favor to be people of love as you have loved us. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he'd given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and he said, Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way also he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Remember us in your kingdom, O Lord, and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, your mercies never fail, and daily you provide for all the needs of this life and everlasting life in Christ. Keep us from being ungrateful for your love and care, and from taking your gifts without a thankful heart to receive your generosity. Grant to us healing, strength, comfort, and peace, that we live in such confidence of the eternal gifts of your Son that he has given to us, that we not despair or grow weary in faith, but be found faithful. When he comes again in glory to bring all things to their fullness through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you peace. Amen.
I'm casting my cares aside. I'm leaving my past behind. I'm setting my heart and mind on you, Jesus. believing there's so much more, knowing that all I have in store for me is good. It's good. Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I won't worry about tomorrow. I'm trusting in what you say. Today is the day. I'm leaving my doubts behind. I'm giving my hopes and dreams to you, Jesus. I'm reaching my hands to yours, believing there's so much more. Knowing that all you have in store for me is good. It's good. Today is the day you have. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I won't worry about tomorrow. I'm trusting in what you say. Today is the day. Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I won't worry about tomorrow. I'm giving you my fears and sorrows. Where you lead me, I will follow. I'm trusting in what you say. Today is the day. Today is the day. Today is the day. Today is the day.
We've received God's peace. Let's pass that peace one to another and take it into our neighborhoods. Go.